Hello everyone. In today's session, we will explore a feature called print management, and it is available in D365 FinOps. Even before this, in previous version also, it was available. So basically, whenever you print a document, document means like purchase order confirmation general is posted, or sales order confirmation is posted, or like invoice for purchase order or sales order, or even free text or other documents are posted, at that time you can save certain settings and configuration in print management, and those settings can be then utilized whenever any for each of the document you can save specific settings. For example, where you want the document print to route, or do you want to archive them or not, or whether what should be the default printing format? Is it a PDF, or is it any other documents which are, I mean, the formats are available in D365. Not only that, but print management also supposed to customize your reports. That definitely will need a developer effort when a developer will duplicate existing, or either from scratch he or she will create a new report, and then you can set that report, I mean, in the print management, and then that format will be used instead of doing so many effort. Like normally developers tend to, you know, create new menu items and things, and then for example, on purchase confirmation or purchase invoice, they used to create you know, the objects in overlayering, which is now neither it is supported and nor it is recommended in D365 FinOps. You always need to create or extend existing objects. Even that is not supported for SSRS, because now you need to always, if you want to duplicate the existing reports, and then you can use that report for your, for example, a company's specific format is used to create a layout or fine tune it as per the company's format. So without any delay, let's go to the print management. And basically, if on the left hand side you can see there are various modules. So for example, if I go to payable, so in the setup itself, in the forms, group of forms, there are specific settings like form nodes, form setup, form sorting parameters. So I will explain a little bit about, I mean, each of these. Basically, these are all the settings relevant with the print management. So when you go to the you know, the forms, forms nodes, and here you can define, you know, the pre-existing, that pre-existing text to be printed. So in a various language you can define it, and you can create a new one, whatever you like. And then I would show you form setup, which is the basic setup. And for example, here you can go to the print management itself, and let me open it. Yeah, so in this tree like node, you can see so many documents on the accounts payable module itself. So for example, if I expand purchase order, there are two settings already exist. One is about original print, and the other one is which I created last time, I think. And you can create as many as you like, but only one will exist for original, and remaining will be as a copy of that you know, the document. So basically, these are I mean, you can see there are various settings like original or copy, whether you can choose original or copy. And original, will you cannot create two original here. And then there are certain default settings, and there is important thing is destination. So whenever you click on the right hand side arrow, there will be a print setup. You can define any any of these formats, whether Excel, CSV, or whatever you like from the existing list. So PDF can be selected, and you can also choose to save as a print archive. So every time a document is printed, it will save an archive version. And also you can direct it to a printer, or you can choose to print on a screen. It is up to you. And you can also select to send it as an email, and that also can be set in batch job. So at a certain stage, it will post it. So let it be selected, the file option, and then you can see here. You can see here the pre-existing formats available for purchase confirmation. So right now only one format is available, and we will dig it down that how to create a new format, and that format how the new format will be available in this option to redirect to that new report format. So basically that is a new report definitely, or of course you cannot create a new design in an existing report. So you have to always duplicate a report, and it's definitely the design will be contained in that report itself. And then there is a certain setting, for example on a footer text, if you have for your company, there is a regular text which you need to appear, which you need to want to appear on every of the print at the footer of your printout. So that can also be set here. So I will just show you. There is this form in various language. You can even create new one, and there will be language options available. So various languages are available, and then you can type a footer text here, and that will appear in each of the print. So you know there are various these settings which are available. So let me introduce you to another option. Normally developers tend to customize that option because they have lack of knowledge. Because of that, they are always customizing it. For example, if you want to print a note on a printout of each or any of the document in the print management, so how to do that? Normally what they do, for example, most of the documents, they have temporary table. They create a new field, and then in the data set that field is then dropped into the design. But there is another there is an existing option in the system itself where you can utilize that that option, and that option is then later on used in your printout. So let me introduce that option to you. For example, we are having a purchase order. So let me go to organization administration. In the organization and administration, you can see there is a document management option here. So in the document management option, let me go to the active document tables. So basically what are these tables? Basically these tables are behind each of the document. For example, if you can see the existing list, so the vendors mean the vendor form itself, and sales order mean definitely the existing sales order. So you can see here sales order confirmation is always enabled. So whatever active document tables are enabled here, so it means these document form itself will allow the attachment. And you can see the attachment, I will show you in a moment. So you can check here, let me sort it as per enabled. So the only sales order confirmation is enabled right now. So let me enable another one, and we will see it. Let me remove the filter here, and now let me choose the purchase order itself. So we are in the active document page, active document table. So what we'll do, we will click a new button, and then in the new button we need to choose, you know, a table name. So basically a table name, for example, if we are talking about purchase order, so purchase order, either we need to know the description or the label or the table behind it, which is purch table. So for example, if I type purchase order, it will filter here, and you know, this is when purch order jar. So purchase order confirmation is also available, and even the purchase order is available. So but still there are so many you know, documents here. We need to choose this one, purchase table. So once we select this table, then we need to enable this table. So once we enable, it means now on, it will allow us to, so it is saying that it is already enabled, so there is no need of again enabling it. So I will delete the record. So here it is there, but it is not enabled. So I will select enable button and save the record. So once I save, it means I have enabled the attachments to go along with the purchase order itself. So let me go to the purchase order page. So it is just a clip icon at the top of the documents. Whatever documents you have enabled the attachment, so it will appear at the top. So for example, if I select this one, so you can see at the top there is a zero number is shown, means there is no attachment right now. And once I click this, so attachment form will be open, and now you have you can see here there is a new command shown here. So if the attachment is not enabled, it will not show you the new command option. So there are various options like file, image, note or URL. All of these options as an attachment can work. So we are interested here in the notes. File means a simple file, PDF or whatever can be attached. So we are interested in the notes, for example. So I will put a note here. A sample note with, for example, terms and conditions. And here you can see there are two options in restriction. One is internal, one is external. So what does it mean? Basically that whenever you are making an internal note, it is for your own purpose. But when you make it as an external note, so it means you want it to print on the external document itself. So I will make it as external here. So that's it. I will save it. And I will close. So now you can see the selected record is showing a number of 1, means there is one attachment that can be either anything. We have seen 4 or 5 options. Any of that thing can be as an attachment. So what we'll do, we will just actually this one is already confirmed, so let me open it. Let me edit the document itself. I can change the quantity to be 900, for example. And then now the confirm option is available. So either I can go from actions or from the generate option. So what is the difference? That when I go to from action, there will be no dialog box open, rather it will directly confirm the document. But I need to go from generate option so that a dialog box is opened. Okay, so the dialog box is now open, and what are the options here? It is saying already by default it is print purchase order as no. I will select as yes. Now you can see there is option use print management destination. So I will just select this option, use print management destination. So let me select as no, posting as no, so that the purchase order is not confirmed. So rather than only we want to preview the confirmation. Let me put a date. That's it, and let me check the preview. Basically, we would have selected the on-screen print rather than PDF. So the now you can see. See here, you can see the terms and condition note here. So the terms and condition is coming from the attachment from the purchase order document itself, and it is can change as per every of the purchase document, and this one is permanent coming from print management form notes. So you can change as per your requirements. Now let's see how to input a footer note for each of the document, that is the purchase order in this case. And this footer text will be permanent because we are putting in form notes itself, form in the print management itself. Let me select a language. Let me select the language first, and then I can input as per any of the language. And I can select a footer text, and so I have I put some text for as a sample. So the company's instruction is footer note, and the destination here, let me select it as screen, save and print archive, no, okay, and that's it. And let me delete this one, just right click and delete it. Now the original will be shown, and the report format is this one, and that's it. Just let me save, control S. Let me go back to the purchase order. Okay, let me go to the, I can also select pro forma confirmation. That means without posting I can preview it. So no need of again unselecting the posting option. So you can see here there is a footer text, and this footer text we have set up in the forms setup in accounts payable, and the same you can do in account receivable or any other module. So the in the similar manner the terms and conditions are also appearing, and that's the simple way how you can put terms and condition or additional company notes in your default printout without doing any coding or any development.